Early last week, a Kampala-bound bus belonging to Link Bus Company overturned at Sebitoli, 2 kilometers from Fort Portal City along the Fort Portal Chenjojo Road, killing 20 people on the spot. Other people died in the hospital. The government then suspended all buses belonging to Link Bus Company for 2 weeks to allow investigations. The Minister of Works and Transport, General Katumba Wamala, today revealed that findings from the investigations conducted following the accident blamed it on a mismanagement on the part of a bus driver.
What looked very evident is that the driver made a poor judgment as he was negotiating that particular part of the road. And there was also evidence which was given by an eyewitness who was closely following the driver and also the fuel tanker which the driver was trying to overtake. The police camera, which was about 3 minutes before the accident site, showed the bus running at a speed of an average speed of 90 kilometers per hour. So, in a nutshell, it was more of human judgment or misjudgment by the driver that caused the accident where we lost the 20 people on the site, and I think they have now gone up to 26.
Consequently, the minister lifted the 2-week suspension that was imposed on the bus company to allow investigations into the deadly crash.
Having gone through all the processes and also being convinced that Link Bus has taken the necessary steps to address the challenges, plus also that Link Bus did not also acted humanely, that they have been able, you know, they met the burial expenses, they've been looking after the injured passengers, but most importantly that they had an elaborate inward look and they have put in place measures to address gaps which were there. And we have decided that Link Bus, now we are lifting the suspension and they can start going back on their routes.
Solomon Simire, the managing director of Link Buses, revealed that during the past 1 week, a lot has been done to ensure that they do not incur similar cases in future. Emphasis has been put on ensuring that all bus drivers are disciplined, have enough rest, and that passengers can report any forms of reckless driving.
We shall have continuous training to ensure that our drivers behave. It's all about behavior on the road. It's not about driving. It's all about behavior. So another thing that we are going to put in place, of course, we already have a code of conduct for all staff and drivers. So we are going to strengthen this code of conduct to ensure that errant drivers are dealt with severely.
The commissioner in charge of transport, Winston Katshabe, has also directed the traffic police to impound all buses and PSV vehicles that do not follow the regulations in place, as well as overworked drivers.
So the issue of the drivers, we had actually arranged it in such a way that the bus cannot make a return journey within a period of 24 hours. Because if you go to Chisoro, you can't reach there and then you say, I can change the driver and another driver drives the bus. The bus also needs some resting, look at a few mechanical issues.
This after numerous complaints that some of the bus drivers are always fatigued.
Human life and human nature is full of contradictions. And these contradictions sometimes deviate from the social order. And it is because of these contradictions that do not conform to social order that police exists. The reason why police exists.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.